Marlon Stewart has always gravitated towards basketball. Every facet of the game, every minute detail, he's always been all in.
Man, I just love being on the floor with my guys, fighting with my team. I love the ups and downs of the game. I love the flows, and I just love the fast-paced action that comes with it.
Marlon Stewart is also intensely competitive, a fact not lost on his former high school and current UND teammate, Cortez Seales.
He's the ultimate competitor. He hates to lose in anything. It'd be a race, connect four, and like literally anything. He just hates to lose.
That competitive fire has helped Stewart and Seales accomplish much together. They captured an Iowa high school state basketball title as seniors before Stewart enrolled at Creighton and Seales at North Dakota. Basketball soon reunited them, with Stewart transferring north following his freshman season. After redshirting in 2017, the 6'3 point guard started every game but one alongside Cortez for the Fighting Hawks last season, finishing in the top 10 in the Big Sky in steals and third on the team in scoring, highlighted by a 29-point masterclass and a conference tournament win over Montana State. All signs pointed to a breakout junior season for the Quad Cities native, but those dreams would have to wait. A tough spring semester in the classroom rendered Stewart ineligible to play in the fall, meaning he'd have to sit for nearly all of UND's non-conference season.
You can get caught up in a lot of things being a college athlete, but you know, books come first, and that's just something I wasn't taking that, you know, making a priority at the time. I found out actually around like the last week of class. I don't know, it was kind of disappointing at first. Tried everything we could, but it didn't work out, and just had to mentally and physically get prepared for the season, knowing I wasn't going to be able to play the first couple games.
I grew up with him, you know, like a brother to me. So when you see one of your brothers down, it does something to you.
It was tough. I mean, because it was like basically like transferring again, not sitting out the whole year, but the first half, you know, just missing those kind of warm-up games.
After receiving the disappointing news, Stewart went to work, stepping up his game in the classroom while contributing in practice, even if playing time wasn't an option.
It motivated me a lot. I mean, my coaches just told me that I needed to focus on things outside of basketball as well. That helped me this semester, or last semester, have a better GPA than I usually have. So it motivated me on the court and for the classroom as well. So I think it helped me a lot.
He actually helped us while he was out, you know, just being on that scout team and competing with us starters at the time. He really helped elevate a lot of us. He helped us as a team. He gave us great looks, you know, playing against some of those other elite players in our league. Marlon's pretty much up there with most of them. We use it to our advantage, you know. He did a great job dealing with that situation.
A motivated Stewart reached his academic goals in the fall, and he was back on the UND roster just before Christmas. After four games of shaking off the rust, Marlon made his way back into the starting lineup in the second week of conference play, and the team's gone 2-1 since.
He's a major part of what we do. You know, most of the ball handling, guarding the other elite guards, you know, and just being that floor general that we know he is.
We're playing at a high level, I think, and we just got to keep going. We got to keep getting better every day.
After being away from the game this fall, Marlon Stewart isn't ready to lose it again anytime soon, especially when time on the courts with one of his oldest friends is winding down. Just another reason for the competitor in him to keep driving forward.
Got to give Cortez and them everything I got. That's the last year. Last year I get to play with them, and then I have one more year going forward. I mean, it's coming to an end. It comes fast, so it's a blessing, honestly. And I love basketball. I'm glad I get to play it.